Rhys, welcome to Swansea City. Really good to have you here. We're now with the deadline day move all done and dusted. You know, how much are you looking forward to getting down to work?
Oh yeah, I'm buzzing. I mean, I've heard nothing but good things about the club, the manager as well, from a few lads back at Liverpool. So I'm buzzing to be here and hopefully get some good results on the board and keep moving forward with the club.
Yeah, I mean, you've enjoyed a breakthrough campaign at Anfield last season, 19 first team appearances, 6 of them in the Champions League, and obviously during that crucial phase towards the end of the season. You know, I guess you're hoping to build on the momentum from that.
Yeah. I mean, no one could have prepared for last season, especially not me, with what happened, especially so many centre-backs going missing through injury. But now I'm just looking for regular football, and hopefully I can find that here at Swansea.
Yeah, I mean, how much confidence have you taken from that experience, though? It must have been a fantastic thing to help Liverpool get into the Champions League, you know, right there at the death, when it was, you know, so important to them to qualify.
Yeah, the last 5 games, Will, we described as the team as 5 finals, so I knew if I could do something good there, then I wouldn't have put myself in bad stead for the rest of the next season coming. But yeah, I mean, the experience was once in a lifetime opportunity. Hopefully now I can bring what I've learnt there and bring it here.
And you know, you played in 4-2 win at Old Trafford with all the attacking talents Man United have. Played in a win against Tottenham with Son and Kane. You know, when you've got those experiences in the locker, I guess that must give you a lot of belief and confidence as you come into this season and wanting to play a regular football in the Championship.
Yeah, I mean, every game in the Premier League comes with a different challenge, from Son and Kane to Cavani and Rashford. I mean, both partnerships brought different things, but I've played against some good players and now I'm ready to bring what I've learnt there straight here.
And you touched on the manager and the style of play a little earlier, but what was it about Swansea that made you believe this is the right move at this time in your career?
Well, I spoke to a few players about it and they've all spoke very highly of the football, the place itself, and there's obviously good history behind the club. And it was one of the places I was keen to come because of the football they play. They're a footballing side, and I think it'll put me in good stead for my future.
Yeah, and you mentioned you spoke to some of the guys here. So I believe you know Morgan Whittaker and Ethan Laird and a couple of the other guys as well.
Yeah, I mean, I spoke to Morgan on the way down, actually. So I was just asking him what's it like, what the lads like, everything. And he had nothing but good things to say. So that's always a positive.
Yeah, and you know, one of the last Liverpool players to come on loan here was Rhian Brewster, who obviously, you know, he had a fantastic time here. You know, are you hoping that you could sort of mirror that and make an impact here to take yourself onto that next level moving forward?
Well, if I get anywhere near as many goals as he did, I think that'll be a miracle. But no, hopefully I can have the same impact that he did, because he did brilliantly when he came here.
Yeah. And you joined Liverpool at the age of 10, Rhys, been there for a long time now. Can you just talk us through who have been some of your biggest influences as you've made those strides through the years at Anfield?
I mean, seeing some of my friends going from playing with me, like Nico Williams and Curtis, going straight to the first team, I thought I wanted a piece of that. And then seeing, obviously, the calibre of players that I would hopefully one day get to play alongside, they've been my biggest influences to want to get to that level.
Yeah, and in terms of some of the coaches you worked with, I think Steven Gerrard was one of your coaches at scholarship level, is that right?
Yeah, I mean, can't say anything bad about Steven, to be fair. He was a great manager. He brought everything he had as a player into his managerial side of things. So, I mean, working with him, dream come true for a lad like me. So, yeah, it was brilliant.
Yeah, I mean, and what did he take in particular from that? I mean, I think I saw an interview you did with Liverpool. He said that he really helped you develop the sort of vocal side of your play and you know, to be a leader, if you like, on the field.
Yeah, he always wanted loud players in his team, so he wanted someone who was going to lead the back line well and demand more from the players in front of whoever was playing there. And he told me pretty early that that's what he wanted from me. So I think that's been a big aspect in my game since working with him, is my vocal ability and my presence to help other players through the game.
And you've obviously played and trained alongside players of the caliber of Virgil van Dijk, you know, Joel Matip, Joe Gomez. You know, how much have you taken from that experience, particularly with, you know, Van Dijk, you know, probably the best pound-for-pound defender in the world?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's been the best for a few years now, and I think he'll continue to keep doing that. But they all have different qualities, and being with them for the year that I was, I've learned bits from all of them. Even when they've been injured, they've been coming to me, telling me what I could do better, stuff like that. So it's been brilliant to work alongside them.
Yeah, and you touched on being vocal, but how would you sum yourself up for any Swansea fans who maybe you know, haven't seen that much of you. What can they expect to see of you in a white shirt?
I'm composed on the ball. I'm dominant in the air, and I'm a presence in defence.
So the style of play suited you perfectly then, Rhys. You know, that confidence on the ball, bravery to play from the back, yeah?
Yeah, that's one of the big things I spoke to with the manager before coming here was the style of play he wants to impose and the ability to play out from the back. I think that's one of the things he identified with me, so I'm looking forward to play that way.
And finally, you know, what do you hope to achieve this season, both on an individual level and on a team level?
I mean, for me, just rack up as many games as I can. I mean, it's a huge experience for me, and it'll be a big thing for me in my career and for the team. I mean, they've been doing brilliantly over the last few seasons, so to get into the playoffs and try and achieve promotion.
Well, fingers crossed, we hope that's what happens, Rhys.
Yeah.
It's good to have you here, mate, and welcome
Thank you.
Once again.
Thank you.